Hey, it's Big T. Welcome and thanks for tuning in to lesson two of How to Tie Flies, a series that I'm putting together to help you go from A to Z on your fly tying skills. So last episode, we basically just talked about tools that you'll need to start out with. We talked about the vise. We talked about a bobbin for your thread, scissors, and some tools necessary for your finishing knot on your fly. So today we're actually going to start wrapping thread and producing a fly. First thing we've got to do is choose a hook. Today we're going to tie a San Juan worm. It's an extremely simple pattern and should be something that hopefully you can put together by the end of this episode. This is a 2X nymph hook here. It's a size 12. That's going to be a pretty good size for you to start out with. The hook that I'm using is a Big T size 12 2X nymph hook. Plenty of opportunities to find nymph hooks. The other materials that you're going to want to have on hand today are going to be some standard ultra chenille. This is easily found. It comes on a cord there. Sometimes it comes just loose. And we're going to actually cut off about a 2-inch piece for our exercise today. That should be sufficient. You can always trim this shorter if you'd like to. And then we need some thread. So I'm using just some similar colored pink thread. And let's talk about thread real quickly. Thread comes in different sizes. It's designated, usually a lot of times will be in denier. The higher the denier number, the thicker the stronger the thread is going to be. Stronger threads, thicker threads allow you to put more pressure as you turn for things like spinning deer hair, putting streamers together. As you migrate into smaller, more delicate flies, you're going to migrate into softer, thinner threads that don't create a lot of bulk as you wrap around, especially for your small dry flies, small nymphs. So keep that in mind. Typically, you're going to look at a 140 denier, a 210, 140, and 70 are probably your most popular out there. I would recommend for this fly trying to start, and when you're starting out, maybe start in the 140 range. Just allows you to get kind of used to doing it without breaking your thread a lot, because that will happen as you migrate to smaller threads. The other designation can be 3-aught, 6-aught, 16-aught, which is a 16/0, 3/0 designations. And in those, the larger number tends to be your smaller. So 3-aught is going to be thicker than a 6-aught. A 16-aught is going to be a really thin thread and something you'd use for really small flies. Hopefully that's helpful. So the first thing we're going to do, obviously, is place our hook in our vise. And that's going to differ based on the type of vise you have. On mine, it simply releases there. I'm going to want to put that hook in at the bend of the hook around the curvature because I want the top shank of this hook to be fully exposed and give me access to that to wrap materials around it. So once you have your hook in place, and we want it nice and secure, we don't want that to be able to move around, we're going to be able to start putting our thread on our hook. Now, if you've got a bobbin and you've got thread and you're having difficulty getting it through the nozzle there is a tool called a threader. Mine's pretty scary beat up. But basically, this is going to be inserted into the bobbin. Let me see if I've got, yeah, I do. You're going to take the end of this and insert through the nozzle all the way through, and then you'll take the threaded piece, go through and pull this back out. That's one way to get your bobbin in thread put together easily. So let's talk about starting our thread wraps. Dominant hand you're going to have, and I'm going to be tying this as a right-hand fly tie, or left-handers I'm sure you're used to and accustomed to adjusting and flipping things around. You want to make sure the tension on your bobbin is such that you can pull thread out It doesn't need to be too easy where it's going to slip and fall. But you need enough tension that it's there and keep things in place, but not so much that when I pull on this, it's going to break the thread. Okay? I'm going to take thread in my left hand, bobbin in right hand, and I'm going to place bobbin in front over the hook, over top of the shank where I want to start wrapping. This hand, my less dominant left hand holding the end of the thread, is going to be towards me. And I'm simply going to start wrapping around the shank. Now, as I begin wrapping, I'm going to pull left hand, less dominant, back down the hook shank towards the bend and wrap that thread over top of it. So what I'm doing now is I've secured this tag piece of thread onto that hook where it won't slide off. It's covered up. I can pull this and everything won't come unraveled. Once I've done that and made several turns over top of this tag thread line, I can trim that off. Boom, we've started our fly. Now you can practice, and be a good exercise simply to practice wrapping back and forth up and down the hook shank. We often talk in terms of wrapping in wrapping in turns that don't overlap, consecutive turns of the thread, and that just gives you a full coverage where you don't have gaps in between. So practice wrapping your thread wraps tightly down the hook, where they're one on top of the other, or right next to each other rather, back and forth. And that will give you a good, what we call thread base. That thread base allows the materials that you're putting on top to stay in place and not slip around. Okay? This is something you may want to do for a little while, back and forth. Take a couple hooks, wrap that back and forth. The next thing that I'm going to teach right now is going to be how to apply and put on a material using a pinch wrap. So I've wrapped my thread to the back bend of the hook right here before the curve. I'm going to get my piece of chenille that I cut, this 2-inch piece of chenille that I cut, and I'm going to place this on top of the hook. It's a little curvy, bendy. Figure out a good way to get it on there where it's just going to lay on top like this. So I've got it on top with my right hand. I've laid it in the position that I want that. We'll move it down a little bit. So I've got about equal distance on both sides of the hook eye and hook bend of chenille. I'm going to transfer over to my left hand, remove my right hand, and pinch. So I've got this material pinched on the back end of the hook. I'm going to bring my bobbin straight up in between my two fingers. I'm going to pull the thread back in between and back over top of the material and the hook. And in doing this, I've now secured this piece of chenille on top. A lot of times you're going to want to make a couple thread wraps around that material using the pinch wrap method. That pinch wrap just makes sure it comes in place where you want it and doesn't twist the material around the shank of the hook. Once we've made a couple wraps like that, I like to take a wrap up and behind that material, that chenille, and then we can start wrapping our thread forward on our hook. And I'm going to wrap this up and leave about a 16th of an inch between the hook eye itself and the material. We're going to sit and look at our chenille again. I'm going to pull it forward on the hook. I'm going to take my left hand and pinch that on top of the hook shank again. And again, I'm going to come up in between my fingers, pinching that thread each time as I come up and over top, and make two or three wraps that way. Once I've done that, it's secured down, I can come over top a couple more times. We've got our chenille secured now on top of our hook. Now we've got to do something to finish this fly. We've got to put a finish knot on. There are two basic types that I like to use. One is a half hitch, and this is going to be the easier of the two. A half hitch tool looks like this. We talked about it last time on the first video. You can actually use a ballpoint pen if you take out the guts. It'll look very similar. So what I'm going to do is I am going to hold in my left hand. I'm trying to think of how to do this. I'm going to hold in my right hand the half hitch tool. And I'm going to hold in my left hand the bobbin. And I'm going to wrap, just like we wrapped our thread over our hook shank, I'm going to wrap two turns over top the half hitch tool, and then I'm going to put the end of the tool, the whole end of the tool, over top the eye of the hook and pull my thread this way towards it. So again, right hand I've got the half hitch tool, left hand I have the bobbin. I'm wrapping over top of the half hitch tool, bringing it over the top of the eye of the hook, and pulling it backwards so that the thread unravels off the half hitch tool onto the hook itself behind the eye of the hook. That's a half hitch knot right there. A few of those should be enough to secure that fly where we can trim it off, the thread off, and be finished. The other is a whip finish. There are a lot of videos on whip finishing, and I'm going to let you try and figure that piece out for yourself, quite honestly, because it's going to depend on the tool that you have. With my style tool, I come in, come over top, and we'll turn. This actually wraps the thread over top of itself. But for time's sake, and I may come back and do a whip finishing video, but I think it might just depend on the tool that you use, so I'm going to leave that up to you. The other thing that you can do is you can do it by hand. There are probably a lot of videos out there by hand. I'm not super good at that. People will say do it by hand, learn by hand, because then that way it doesn't matter what tool you have, you always have one on you. You don't have to, wherever you go, there, and you can do that by hand as well. So that's basically our San Juan worm. We'll trim the thread here. The one thing that is kind of a secret, not necessarily a secret, but a trick to do once you finish the fly, is to actually get a lighter out and burn both ends. I know I've got one, so I have it right here. So what we're going to do is take the lighter, just sends the end off, and it gives it a nice tapered look. So that's going to be the fly. That's going to be our second lesson, how to wrap thread on a hook and pinch wrap our material down. Tune in for lesson three. Lesson three, I'm going to start working with dubbing and how to apply dubbing onto your thread and use dubbing on a fly. We'll be tying a waltz worm in the next episode. Hope you're enjoying this. Follow along. Should be a few days before that comes out. That'll give you some time to practice this fly and practice putting thread on your hook. For materials and other instructional videos, please visit www.bigtflyfishing.com, and I would certainly appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel. Thanks so much.